was steering, cruising to a better vision, y'all. Can you hear me? Can you hear me now? Can you hear me? Can you hear me now? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Hear me now? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Hear me, hear me, hear me now? Can you hear me? Hear me, hear me, hear me, hear me, hear me now? Mama, 30 the roads that I've traveled, but I'm on my way. Mama, trust all the steps on my journey, cause I'll be okay. I know it's gotta hurt, when you know you could've had a president. Guess that I would rather be the man. Maybe one day I'll go back to school. Think I'm predicated, but I still mean it. They've been trying to screw me, but I've been a genius. Daddy looking more like home since I made moves. Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Can you hear me now? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Hear me now? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me now? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Hear me? Hear me? Hear me now?
Money back. Money back. Money back. Moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Indianapolis Colts and the Jacksonville Jaguars. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple of extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. So get it up to about the 28-yard line. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine. To throw on second down. Finley over the middle, complete. It's Doyle. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 16 yards to pick up there. The Colts have a first down.
His position, and he's listed as a tight end, but he certainly doesn't run like one. And that's what we're seeing more and more coming into the league. Those guys who can run, make plays after the catch, and gain that additional yardage.
And using that speed there to turn it into a pretty nice little game. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down. He was well over 100 yards last week. He told us this week, a little ambitious, said he wants to hit that 200 mark. We'll see.
Makes sense, though, doesn't it? Have we ever run into a running back that had a great game the week before that didn't think that's just going to naturally continue, just make sure you feed me the football? And that's what they're all about. Continuity, rhythm, number of carries, just keep giving it to him.
Right back to him on first down. And he's going to get stopped up quickly. Give him a yard down to the 43.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Looking to throw on second down. Finley, quick hitter here, it's complete. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. The reception good for seven. It's third down. On third and two, Finley got his hand complete over the middle. That's Cannon. That one good for seven as this long drive continues and the chains move again. Pretty solid start for the rookie here on this first drive, Charles.
Able to have some confidence, stepping back into the pocket, move around a little bit, find open receivers, and deliver. That just means his confidence is going to continue to grow because he's getting more and more comfortable with each completed pass.
That loss of three, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's second and 13. They'll run with Mac, and he will cross the 30 down to the 29-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, but they've only got it back to third and 10.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
All right, now, lock it 56. Lock it.
On third down, Finley. Oh, a scrap for the football, and he's going to come down with it. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. I don't think it's a surprise they're throwing the football early. We expected that. They told us they were going to come out firing, but 4 for 4 on the opening drive, they like that.
They don't just like it. They love it because now everyone gets locked in. Your confidence jumps up. Everyone's easy about what they're doing out there. And by the way, they're looking at the sideline thinking to themselves and expressing, let's keep throwing it. We're doing pretty well.
It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be second and goal. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the Stop Troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
The line of scrimmage, the seven now on second and goal. They go option right on second and goal. And he takes this one in for a Colts touchdown. It's their quarterback, his second touchdown on the season. And the Colts take it right down and score on the opening drive. Santos with the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Now they'll run it on the toss. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. The drive starting play, a good one. Give him 19. If you start assessing what went wrong last week, Charles, in their loss, had nothing to do with the ground game. They ran it well.
And you also have to say to yourself as a team, don't go away from what worked. That's not the reason the game was lost. Running the football over time, when you do it consistently, usually translates into wins.
And they're hoping to do it consistently here. Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down.
Mexico.
Running game working. They'll stick with it on first down. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Here's Luck now on second down. Trying to lay one up deep. And they went for a big play through the air on second down. Couldn't connect. Now it's third.
But that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Off of play action, Luck forced out to his left. Now he'll throw deep left. He's got it. Hit the 15. A big play that time for Jacksonville. 46 yards.
In our pregame meeting, all they talked about was keeping him hemmed in and wanting him to make his throws from the pocket because they knew he was pretty dangerous if he got outside, and he just showed it right there. Pretty good arm, too.
Now they'll run it on the toss. A good display of power, but it will only get him just inside the 5 to the 4. Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's 2nd and 2. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. Just a gain of 1 yard there, and now it'll be 3rd down. The good run on first down followed up by a not-so-good run on second down.
Now let's find out they're going to stick with the run here on third down. A lot of people would love to see some play action here. I say go with your best running play over your best blocker.
And now here's a timeout called by the Colts on the defensive side of the ball. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Line of scrimmage, the 2. They can still get a first down if they just get 1 yard out of this on 4th and very short. Now they'll run it on the toss. And this is going to be nowhere close. Needed some inches and ended up losing yardage. They'll get neither the touchdown nor the first down. And that will force a turnover on downs. The 4th down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. They begin the drive on the ground with Mack. And he'll take this up to about the 7 or 8 yard line. Telvin Smith that time there to make the play.
And that's frustrating for a defense because they've got them pinned down deep. And on the first play, they gave up a run that keeps an offense on schedule.
Yeah, because 3 to 4 yards, that's all you're looking for right there, right?
That's absolutely perfect, really, as a play call. You get 3 to 4 yards on first down, that's what they talk about to us all the time, about being ahead of the chains or on target, ahead of schedule. They were after that run.
Now Mack. And he's up past the 10 to about the 12. Call it a gain of 5 there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or two short here with third down coming up.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
On third down, it's Mack, and they're going to get the first down here as he's up to the 14. They only get 2 there, but on 3rd and 1, that's all they needed to keep the drive going.
Leopard! Leopard!
Here's Matt. And a nice gain there as he'll be taken down just shy of the 20. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up 2nd down.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. Before he was planted in the backfield. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll make it 3rd down.
Detroit! Detroit!
Operating from the gun, Finley. Looking left side of him, he's got a man. That's Doyle. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
Nice job, nice patience right there. Put him on the right side, let him work his way across, put the ball in his hands, and let him work his way upfield with a catch.
So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38.
Over.
And they'll try the ground game here with a running back. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8. You mentioned very early on the need to establish a running game for this young QB. They really haven't been able to do that, though, in the first half.
So that means what in halftime? Adjustments. Time, right? Figure out what they are. Figure out the things that they really want to accomplish and who to run behind. Which are your better blockers? Find those guys and get in that direction.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Indianapolis moving the chains there on a gain of 12. So in Jacksonville territory now, here's a 1st and 10 at the 48-yard line. And they'll run it here. And that play goes nowhere. Taken down, losing yardage at the 50, right at midfield. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And that'll make it 2nd and 12. A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's 2nd and 12. Now we've got whistles and a flag. Looked like one of the Colts linemen might have jumped. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. 2nd down and long. From the gun, Finley. He rifles one that's intercepted. picked off by Tashaun Gibson, and the return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line.
Well, the timing is everything on a route like this. He tried to drive that football into a tight spot. And if you're a little early or a little late, chances are there's going to be someone there. And sure enough, this one's going the other way.
And on the ground they go with the running back. And they went the wrong way there, losing yardage back at the 43-yard line.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral-type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
The beauty of being able to play a zone defense, when you can sit back and see the ball coming out of the quarterback's hands, guess what? Creates a lot of confusion, kind of a muddle in the middle of the field where you go make a play on the football.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. A shotgun snap for Love. The open man is Shark. It's complete. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. The 21 yards there as they convert on third. Now it's Love. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Seems like this defense, especially the secondary, has really been contesting about every throw in this first half.
Remind me of a good half-court defensive basketball team. Every time a pass is thrown, they're right there in good defensive position, able to affect the play.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And that one blown up quickly as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down. Throwing on third down, Luck.
Bobby, you mind if I take off this headset and put on a coaching headset?
You want to get this running game going?
I want to get this running game going. I'm going down there and saying, gentlemen, we have got to run the football. We've got to get it going right now.
Yeah, to this point in the second quarter, it has been a struggle. And he has got it from 55 yards away. That was never in doubt. These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny? When we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right, baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
Trying to shake off the interception, he'll look to throw. Jaguar pressure and a Jaguar sack.
I know there'll be a little bit of criticism there because they went right back to the air after the huge pickup and ended up getting sacked.
All right, now, look
that's often
six.
A play
look
that you make. You feel like you've got momentum on your side.
Unfortunately, the O-line failed to hold up to try to keep that momentum going. And that false start penalty is certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long.
Here we go. 3-19.
Operating from the gun. Finley. It's complete here to T.Y. Hilton. And he's brought down after a very nice game. An excellent pickup of 34 yards.
There will always be a place for methodically marching the ball downfield. But when you can pick it up in big chunks and strike like that and have explosive plays, that's often the difference. Winning and losing. Those types of plays that can knock a defense off balance, that'll drive a team towards a victory.
From the midfield strike, they'll look to throw. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he'll go down, but not before getting this Leopard, inside the Leopard. 30. A good pickup there, a 22.
But when you hit him on the move like that, and he's able to get into open field with a full head of steam, oh boy, it's going to be tough to get him down.
Yeah, there was a big window. They're lucky they did get him down. But now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. So now they'll come up on second and 10, once again from the 28. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Back-to-back stops, make it third and 10.
Well, he didn't make headway on that one, but he's had plenty of carries all night long. I just wonder if maybe he's a little bit tired from toting the rock that much.
To throw on third down, Finley. And he's got his man, Hilton. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. The passing game for the Colts finding its stride, another first down. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. And he spots Henderson, open left side. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. The completion good for three, and it's second down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there, swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
The Colts on third down. No problems to this point. A perfect 5 for 5. This will be third and 6. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. Back with more from Jacksonville. Don't go anywhere. We'll be back after this. On third down, Finley. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Marcel Darius. Able to drop him for a loss of 2. And that'll bring up fourth down. On fourth down, Finley. It's complete. Swings it out to his running back. And he's not even going to come close. A big loss in the wrong direction on fourth down. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As they'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Now they'll run it on the toss. Got some room at the 30. And finally brought down at the 34-yard line. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive. First down.
Well, so much for him being bottled up throughout the day. Finally finds a way to break through and get a really nice gain. The defense had felt great about what they had going. Now they've got to turn their attention to getting it back in that direction. Can they bottle him up again? Because I'd say after that run, confidence is pretty high for him.
On first and 10, Locke. Flushed out right. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
Appeared to me he was just trying to find an open receiver and got forced out to his right. Had to come off of a guy downfield, trying to hit his back. Unable to connect. Should have been an easier throw moving to his right, though.
Yeah, much easier, obviously, for a right-handed quarterback who's going to his left. From the tougher.
Exactly.
On the move to his left. And he comes back with one complete. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. A 14-yard first down pickup for the Jaguars. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. They go play action here on first down. They'll roll him out right. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
They've been playing sound fundamental defense thus far and able to keep this offense from creating a major dent on the scoreboard.
Able to force the incompletion, but still waiting for that game-changing play. You feel like it's coming, the first sack, the first turnover.
In a sense, they're playing old-school defense right now. The new school defense is what you said, taking the ball away.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well. The Jaguars on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is third and 10.
Got
Throwing again is Lott. Sliding out of the pocket. Wide open receiver complete. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead, as the clock will stop with 35 seconds to go in quarter number two. Letting one go deep for the end. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Able to get there and pick it. And he will bring it out past the 20-yard line. Unfortunately for him, if last week was any indication, we knew a pick was coming at some point. Last week it was interception after interception, and here we go again.
We actually quit counting last week at a certain point because I thought I was going to run out of fingers, all right, because I'm not all that skilled as a mathematician. But you're right. It felt like a matter of time, and you've got to think the guys on defense, they couldn't wait for this opportunity after what they saw on tape.
A run by Mack to start the drive. Oh, he's got some breathing room. A big seam, and he might go all the way. Touchdown, Indianapolis. A great play there as the first half is winding down. And the Colts strike quickly here for 6 points. And with that carry, he's already over 100 yards here in the first half.
And, partner, you know exactly what he's saying to his teammates right now, right? Especially to the play caller.
Give me the ball.
Again. And again. And again. It's not that heavy, sir. I'll take it. And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
Very good starting field position for the Jaguars offense as they come up first and 10. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. Second down is Lott. Escaping the pressure right. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. So we are at halftime here on a Monday night as we now go downstate to Orlando and check in with Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This fielded at the two. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Out come the Jaguars now as they'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is
a
I'm doing it though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. Second down, here's Lott, eluding the pressure right. Now he's going to throw it, and got his man, complete. He's at the 30, and he'll be taken down inside Indy's 15-yard line. It's a big play for the Jaguars, 66 yards. A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. And they'll go on the ground. And he's going to battle his way down right around the 2-yard line. Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1. They'll give it to him right up the gun.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
1st and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Now they'll run it on the toss. And they'll take this one in for a Jags touchdown. A great effort there. His 21st touchdown of the season. And the Jaguars have cut it back within a score. Now Mike Tomlin says, let's go ahead and go for 2. Love. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete. Tough there. Good pass. Hit the hands. He just couldn't bring it in.
And every receiver's coach everywhere seeing that play, focus, focus, focus. Watch it all the way in and tuck it away.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Here's the Colts now as they get ready for their first possession on offense of the second half. And coming off a one-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here and stop this offense?
Well, hopefully there's some determination that sets in because they weren't ready to go on the last one. Give all the credit to the offensive guys for getting it done, but to allow a run of that length, that's just not being prepared. So now, are they determined? Are they ready to read their keys and make the proper plays?
And we'll see how determined they are.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
They had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on 2nd and 10.
Detroit! Detroit! Now let's go! Green, 39!
To throw on 2nd down. Finley, and the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete.
We've seen good cover skills on display throughout this game, really from both teams. And there's another nice example there of them making it difficult to complete a pass.
Big play coming up. Here's 3rd and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
Flex round! Flex round!
The pressure drops off as they'll look to throw. He's going to fire this thing deep right sideline. And a shot taken on 3rd down, unsuccessful. 4th down now.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? The zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on 3rd down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. 3rd down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him. I know there's no magnet in the ball, but sometimes for the punt returner, after such a scramble, it sort of feels that way, doesn't it? He has it. He loses it. Somehow the ball finds its way back to him.
Atone for his sin, and you know he's taking a deep sigh of relief right now. And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on 1st down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable 2nd down. A very solid gain on that play.
Back to throw, Love. Now they set up the screen, that's complete. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues. Now a handoff looking right. He'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That burst good for 20 and a first down.
A good run there off right tackle in an old school NFL football. The right side, the offensive line, often known as the nasty side. The left side, usually the technical side. Kind of reminds me of the old Atlanta Falcons 2009-2010. That's how they constructed their offensive line.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. The gun. Here's Locke. Stepping up, he'll try and run. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. 6 yards there off the scramble, but it'll still leave him with a third down. The Jaguars on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. Here's Locke. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. A 14-yard first down pickup for the Jaguars. He's already proven to be a factor in the running game on this drive. Now he gets involved in the passing game.
I think what we're seeing here is the modern version of workhorse in the NFL, being able to run it and catch it with equal proficiency.
He'll get this down inside the 10 for a pickup of about 3.
They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far.
And he will fight his way into the end zone for a touchdown. A great play there. Touchdown number 22 on the season. And the Jags are able to cash in for 6. Well, this offense only mustered 3 points in the first half on that field goal. They picked up the pace now. 2 third-quarter touchdowns.
Hey, you remember that appearance we had last week in front of that crowd? And they asked about halftime adjustments and all that was going on. And remember what I said. It's not always an adjustment at halftime. Sometimes just remembering the game plan and playing better, tuning it up and just working through it methodically, they got it done in this case.
Of course, I'll always remember that appearance because I had on a brown belt with black shoes and you pointed that out in front of the crowd. So thanks for that.
I said that out loud.
You did.
Yeah, my bad.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. And the Colts coming out now. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
Well, you had to punt on your first drive, and on the first play of the second drive, you end up going backwards. I would dare say they need something good to happen right here, right now.
And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and all of a sudden here, it's 3rd down.
Well, it's tough to be a defender in today's NFL because there's so many things to account for in today's passing game, including the back sneaking out of the backfield. Not quite as bad as a turkey bowl where you have that center-eligible stuff, but still, a lot of guys to account for.
The Colts on 3rd down, they've been very good, 5 for 7 thus far. This will be 3rd and 5. And here comes throw number 1 for the backup QB. Throwing middle, and it's complete. And now off to the races, down the right side. Touchdown, Indianapolis. A big play there. His first touchdown on the year. And the Colts are in for 6.
Here we go now. Green, 39.
From the gun. Finley, and it's intercepted at the goal line. Snags it for the pick, and a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Fielded about a yard deep.
but he stopped where he ultimately would have been had he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. The Jags offense now gets set and heads back onto the field. Toss. And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Partner, I think from our experience together, we have learned that most offensive coordinators are going to tell you, if I'm going to run the football on first down, I've got to get at least 4 yards. They got five here. They've got to feel pretty good about that one.
Now a play fake, and it's locked. Steps away. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations, because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. Quarterback was hit.
From the gun on third down, Luck. Flush to his right. Open man right side is Sharp. And they work this well upfield across the 45. And they convert on third with a gain of 22. Those are the kinds of plays right there that show you why he's the number three man in the NFL in terms of receiving yards.
Also tells you there's a full combination of what he's got going in his game. You name it, from route running to catching the football. That's why he's able to produce those types of numbers.
And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Go ahead. Now they'll run it on the toss. Room to run inside the 40. And finally brought down at the 38. That one good for a gain of 13 for Jacksonville and a first down.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Now a first down throw. Lock. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. Only three there on the screen. It's second down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed. But all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
Now they'll run it on the toss. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 6 yards on the pickup, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Nice job there defensively on third down. Not only did they string the play out, but they didn't allow any room for a cutback. Really well organized on the defensive side.
The Jaguars on third down. They've been very good, 5 for 7 thus far. Here it's third and two. Out of the gun, Luck, rolling to his left. And he's taken down, trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack. And no matter what the situation, the O-line just hates that because they feel like they didn't protect little brother back there, right?
Man, that's just so difficult for them because just think about every single play. When you decide to throw the football, you're dealing with some of the best athletes on the planet. You talk about guys, if they weren't playing football, they'd be starring in the NBA at power forward. It's a really difficult task.
1 score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down.
12.
Alert. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And no, it's incomplete. Mike Tomlin takes a shot here, but to no avail. And the Colts are going to take over with a football. And the Colts getting ready to go. Their defense forced the turnover on downs. They've got the lead. They're in good shape, but can't go into a shell here, right? Still got to be careful.
Yeah, because they're still a long way away from kneel down time. So they've got work on getting first downs. Keep the sticks moving, right? Keep the clock going. And above all, ball security. Don't turn it over.
And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. For the opening play, the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12. They stay on the ground. Again, it's Hines. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Call that a loss of 5 yards on the play. And they're going to be staring at a third and long here. So time to start going in the other direction as they come up now third and long.
Detroit!
Throwing on third and long. Finley. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play. And the officials are instructed, if there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. Here comes the Jaguars offense as they get set here. They had a great drive going last time. They were moving the ball, and then all of a sudden it just stalled out. So we'll see what they can do here, Charles.
And it's always easy to second guess when you don't get it on a fourth down try. But they had to like the feeling that they had going on offense. They want to continue to see if they can capture that again on this drive and maybe get in the same position.
Yeah, and that's, I mean, like I said, they were moving the football. It's not like they went four and out, so I don't think it's a deal where the offense doesn't have confidence.
No, I agree with you totally on that one. If anything, they may have gained more confidence. Okay, they stopped us once. That's all right. Let's keep moving it. Make them do it again.
Here's Luck now on second down. Sharks got it left side. And he'll be out of bounds near the 30. In fact, right on the 30. A Jacksonville first down on a pickup of 17. Luck now perfect since the second half started. 7 of 7. It's first and 10. Now they try the right side here. And he's got a good gain of 7 up to the 37.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball, but when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
Now they'll run it on the toss, and he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
This is third and 2. Maybe the biggest play in this football game. A shotgun snap for Luck. He's got the hookup to Lee. First time they've looked his way in this game. He comes through picking up the first.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route. Drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
Now a play fake here on first down. He's going to let it fly. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. He'll look to throw. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete. So he's unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark, really, start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here, or is he just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
They'll look to throw. Being chased out left. Now a desperation throw. This is caught at the 20. And he just falls short down at the 1 yard line. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. And now here's a timeout called by the Colts on the defensive side of the ball. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Jacksonville. A great effort there with touchdown number 23 here on the year. And the Jaguars have moved out in front here in the fourth quarter. So here we go now as the Jaguars will go for two. Incomplete.
I think we can figure out why they went for two there, right? Up one, you want to make it a field goal difference if at all possible. They didn't get it. Now they've got to play some defense down the stretch.
Yeah, not much margin for error now for your D. They just have to get it into range. This is Fielded at the goal line. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. The Colts now, their offense works their way back onto the field. They punted last time they had it. What steps, Charles, do you think they have to take to make sure they don't do that again?
Well, let's just go to the football 101, the trite expression 101. Win first down. Make 5, 6, 7 yards on first down and make it a 2nd and 3, 2nd and manageable. Keep accumulating first downs that way. Keep moving the football. Don't want to get behind the sticks because then the defense has the advantage.
And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up 2nd down.
Work with me, partner. Take a deep breath because that's what they're doing down the field now. That incompletion allowed them to exhale a little bit. Get in the huddle. Kind of scan the crowd. See if any celebrities are here. Relax a little bit as they start this big drive.
Steps away to his left. And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off at the 40. And the return here will go to the 31-yard line. If you combine last week and this week, he's got a hat trick going because he had 2 interceptions a week ago.
He's seeing the ball so well and understanding where receivers are and positioning. I mean, just watching him work with such great technique and paying it off by actually catching the ball when he has a chance, he's helping his team in a huge way.
And they'll go with a ground attack here. And he'll be brought down somewhat awkwardly here and a late flag as well. I think this one's going to be a face mask. And now it's 1st and 10. A big mistake, especially when you factor in the personal foul yardage. And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. And another timeout taken by the Colts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming 2nd down play. And they'll run it here. Oh, no, he lost the football. And the offense will get this one back. Boy, that could have been catastrophic at this late stage of the game, but they avoid disaster. Now they'll run it on the toss. And they go the wrong way on this one. Losing yardage back at the 12. He lost 2, and it brings up 4th.
But that certainly felt like an example of a defense just saying, okay, we've had enough. We've gotten mashed all night long. About time we got a good play in. But flip it over to the offensive side. They've got to be really upset that they allowed a play like that to happen. They were pitching such a great game. They want to keep it going.
Now let's see how the offense still out there. They elect to go on 4th and 11. And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. And a movement there coming from the middle of the line.
And you understand he wants to get off the ball quickly, but the ball's right in front of him. He has to watch it move first.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. And Lambeau will put this one through. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in three. So they get the three, but you wonder now, is that going to be enough?
Excellent question, because when I look at the smiles on that side of the field, it's a little tight, aren't they? If they had scored a touchdown there, those would be big half-moon grins right now because they'd feel a whole lot better about their position.
And a touchdown in the other direction, all of a sudden they're down. Game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play where still you were wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.
So for the Jaguars, the win here means it'll be a 7-1 first half of the season. And they'll have another home date next week as the Kansas City Chiefs come to town. Meanwhile, for Indianapolis, they drop back to 500 now at 4 up and 4 down. And they'll be at home for one next week as the Atlanta Falcons come to town. So for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. Next game, guess what? Charles and I will be here again. It's the NFL on EA Sports.